الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن خير الكلام كلام الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد All praise is due to Allah We Lord Him beseeches help and in Him we seek forgiveness And we seek the refuge of Allah Tabarak wa ta'ala From the mischievousness of our souls And from the wrongdoings of all of our actions Whomever Allah guides, no one will be able to lead him astray. And whomever Allah leaves to be left astray, no one will be able to guide him. And I bear witness that there is nothing worthy of worship as a deity except Allah. He is alone, he has no partners. And I bear witness that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his abd, his slave, and his rasul, his messenger. O you who believe, fear Allah. Fear Allah with the fear that is due to Him. And do not die except as Muslims. O human beings, fear your Lord who created you from one soul, and from that one soul his mate. And from the two of them, men and women spread abroad in multitudes. Remember the wombs that bore you, and keep the relations of family ties amongst you. For surely Allah is a raqib, is a watcher over you. O you who believe, fear Allah. And say that which is correct. Allah will repair all of your affairs for you. And forgive you of all of your sins. And whomever obeys Allah and His Rasul, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, they have achieved the greatest of success in the dunya and in the akhirah. As to what proceeds, surely the best speech is the book of Allah. And the best guidance is the guidance and the sunnah of our beloved Prophet Muhammad, صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم and the worst of all affairs are newly invented matters for every newly invented matter is an innovation every innovation is a going astray and every astray is in the hellfire inshallah brothers if you can move up a little inshallah to give the people room that are coming in late Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has created the human being with a heart. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the human being with a nafs. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created two creatures, both of them having similar attributes, both of them having hearts, and both of them having nafs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the human being, and He has created the jinn being. There is the jinn kind, and there is humankind. And from amongst those creatures called the jinn and the human being, we have shayateen. We have devils. From amongst the jinn, and from amongst the human being, we have devils. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as a test on the human being, and as a test on the jinn being, has allowed the devils, the shayateen, from amongst both of those creatures, to whisper to them. And he has also allowed as a test, as a trial, in this dunya, for us to be whispered to by our nafs. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who received the Book of Allah, the glorious, noble Quran, in many places, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about the jinn. And in many places, Allah azza wa jal informed the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam about the nafs. And he informed the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that this nafs whispers to us. That this nafs, along with the shayateen, along with the jinn, whom we cannot see with our physical naked eye in this life, and amongst those shayateen, amongst the human beings, they whisper to us, and our nafs also whispers to us. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say to them, أعوذ برب الناس, I seek refuge with the Lord, the Creator, the Owner, the administrator of all the affairs of his creatures, the Rabb of the human beings, the King and the Master of the human beings, the God of the human beings, min sharril waswasil khannas, from the whispers, the evil suggestions of that creature called khannas, that creature that Allah created, that is a jinn, that has comrades from amongst the human beings, that whispers, الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ النَّاسِ, the one that whispers to the hearts inside the chests of the human beings, مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ, from among the jinn, shayateen, the devils from among the jinn, and the devils from amongst the human beings. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, elsewhere in his book, he says, وَلَقَدَ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْنَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ. And surely we have created the human being, and we know when his nafs whispers to him. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in almost every khutbah, for Jumu'ah, in almost every khutbah for Jumu'ah, and in other affairs of importance, he used to make that which is called khutbatul haja. Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiru. Surely the praise is for Allah. We laud Allah. We beseech Allah for help and forgiveness. وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ شُرُورِ أَنفُسِنَا, and we seek the refuge of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala from the evil, meaning the evil suggestions that come to our nafs inside of us, from our nafs. We seek refuge with Allah from our nafs whispering to our nafs. We seek refuge with Allah from the evil suggestions of our nafs that Allah created, that He knows which whispers to us, whispers to ourselves. And Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Rabbi الناس ملك الناس إله الناس. We thank Allah, the God of mankind, the King of mankind, the Lord of mankind, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has absolved this ummah from evil suggestions that they may have, from thoughts that comes to their minds, that comes into their hearts, that comes into their chest, from the shayateen, the devils, or from their nafs. Allah has pardoned us. And we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has pardoned us. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَجَاوَزَ لِي عَنْ أُمَّتِي مَا حَدَّثَتْ بِهِ أَنفُسُهَا مَا لَمْ تَعْمَلْ أَوْ تَتَكَلَّمْ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has said that Allah has absolved, Allah has pardoned, Allah has excused this ummah, my ummah, from every single thing that comes to their minds, from every single thought that comes to their minds, as long as they don't do it or say it. Because we know, brothers and sisters, the human being is created weak. The human being is a creature that can't control himself. The human being has a nafs. The human being has the shayateen from amongst the jinn and the men, those devils that whisper, do this, do that, say this to that sister, say that to that brother, take your hand and strike him, don't give him his money back, shoot him in the head, go commit zina with that woman, steal this, do that, say this. Allah Azza wa Jal has pardoned this ummah from every single evil suggestion that comes to our minds, مَا لَمْ تَعْمَلْ أَوْ تَتَكَلَّمْ, as long as we, you, I, the ummah of Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, does not put it into practice or let it come off their tongues, we're excused. And you know, brothers, and you know, barakallahu feekum, my beloved brothers and sisters, we all know some of the suggestions that comes to our minds. And we don't think that the human being is so special that he's never going to have evil thoughts come to him. For there is no one greater after the prophets and the messengers, the Anbiya and the Rusul. There's no people, there aren't any people in existence until Yawm al-Qiyamah that are greater than the companions of the Messenger of Allah. No one. No one is greater than the companions of the Messenger of Allah after the prophets and the messengers, there's no one greater. And we know that the companions of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, used to have evil suggestions. The companions of the Messenger of Allah used to have, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, evil suggestions. As one narration says, فَجَاءَ نَاسٌ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ النَّبِيِّ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam فَسَأَلُوهُ إِنَّا نَجِدُ فِي أَنفُسِنَا مَا يَتَعَاذَمُ بِهِ مَا يَتَعَاذَمُ أَحَدُنَا أَن يَتَكَلَّمَ بِهِ. The companions of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a part of them, a party from among them, used to come to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asking him, O Messenger of Allah, inna najidu fi anfusina ma yata'adhamu ahaduna an yatakallama bi. O Messenger of Allah, we have some things that come to our minds, we have some evil suggestions that come inside of our heads, we have some thoughts, some wasawas, some waswasa, some suggestions, some whispers that come to our minds that are so great, that are so horrendous, that are so despicable, that are so evil, that are so tumultuous on the scale that if we were to say them, we're afraid to even these are the people whom Allah said, رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُمْ. Allah is pleased with them, and they are pleased with Him. Allah is pleased with them, and they are pleased with Him. We have things that come to our minds, things that are so great and so evil, we're afraid to even say them. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَقَدْ وَجَدْتُمُوهُ. Do you really see, find things like that inside yourselves? You mean you really find things, evil suggestions like that inside yourselves? قَالُوا نَعَمْ. They said, yes. Yes, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. فَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ ذَاكَ سَرِيحُ الْإِيمَانِ. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, that is pure Iman. That is pure Iman. Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullahu ta'ala, in explaining the statement of the Messenger of Allah, ذَاكَ سَرِيحُ الْإِيمَانِ, that is pure Iman, he said that this doesn't mean that the evil suggestions is pure Iman, but that when they had the suggestions, that they wanted to keep it inside of themselves and were afraid to say it or do it is Sarihul Iman, pure Iman. And the other narration, it says that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, ذَاكَ أَوْ ذَلِكَ مَحْطُ الْإِيمَانِ. That is pure, unadulterated Iman. And in the other narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Alhamdulillahi alladhi radda kayd ash-shaytan ila al-waswasa. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, three times. Praise be to Allah, the one that repelled and diminished the tricks and the subterfuge and the plots and the evil plans of Shaitan down to just a whisper. That he diminished the kaid, the tricks of Shaitan when he whispers to you, or your nafs whispers to you, or that devil from amongst the human beings who calls you on the phone or sends you an email telling you to do such and such, or to say such and such, or that sister calls you on the phone and says, say this to that sister, or go to a house and do this. Alhamdulillah alladhi radda kayd ash-shaytan ila al-waswasa. Praise be to Allah that He diminished the trick of our avowed open enemy, Iblis, Shaytan, to just a whisper, so that we won't say it, nor will we do it, because we're excused if it's just a thought. Walillahi alhamd. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Hamdan kathiran tayyiban mubarakan fi kama yuhibbu Rabbuna wa ma yarda. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in amma ba'd. My beloved brothers and sisters in al-Islam, those of you who are created weak, those of you who are created fragile, those of you who are a creature that when Allah formed Adam in Jannah, our father, your father, and Iblis started going around him, looking at him, he saw that he was a hollow. He saw that he was a creature that was made up of a substance not able to control himself. My beloved brothers and sisters in al-Islam, you have been blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have the book of Allah revealed to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and explained to the companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who were human beings who had suggestions of evil and whispering like yourselves. Walillahi alhamd, the ulama of al-Islam have delved into the book of Allah and the sunnah of our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and the explanations and examples of the sahaba of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wasallam, and they have derived principles, a formula, or formulas that will enable us to get rid of these suggestions, to fight against these thoughts. Because the creature, whatever he does, sister, it begins with a thought. There's nothing that you do, brothers, except that it begins with a thought. Everything that comes to our minds, everything that we say or we do, it begins with a khatra. It begins with a thought. And this is why the ulama of al-Islam, they say, فَدَابِعِ الْخَطْرَ فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلْ صَارَتْ فِكْرَ. You should fight, ward off, and defend yourself from thoughts. And if you don't do that, then it becomes an idea. فَدَابِعِ الْفِكْرَ. Then fight or ward off the idea. فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلْ صَارَتْ شَهْوَةً. If you don't fight off the thought, ward yourself from the thought, protect yourself from the thought, then that thought will grow and it will become an ideology. It will become an idea. And if you don't take care of that idea, if you don't fight it, then it will become desire. It will become desire. فَحَارِبْهَا. The ulama say, now you have to make jihad on it. When it becomes a desire, now you have to make war on it. There has to be harb. There has to be war on your desires. فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلْ. And if you don't ward off that, if you don't defend yourself from the desire, which originally was a thought, then grew to an idea, if you don't do that, فَصَارَتْ صَارَتْ عَظِيمَةً وَهِمَّةً. Then it becomes determination and resolve. Then it becomes determination and resolve. فَإِن لَمْ تُدَافِعَهَا صَارَتْ فِعْلًا. And if you don't ward off and defend yourself from those determinations and those resolves inside of yourself, then it will undoubtedly, without doubt whatsoever, become an action. It will become an action. فَإِن لَمْ تَتَدَارَكُوا بِدِدِّهِ صَارَ عَادَةً فَيَصْعَبُ عَلَيْكَ الْإِنْتِقَادُ عَنْهَا. And if you don't fight and protect yourself by changing that thing with its opposite, if you don't bring the opposite of that action, then it's going to become a habit. And human beings are creatures of habit. And once it becomes a habit, it's going to be very, very difficult for you to get rid of it. It's going to be very, very difficult for you to get rid of it. It all begins with a khatra. It begins with a thought. The evil suggestion comes from shaitan, whether it's that brother, or that kafir, or from that jinn that you can't see, or your nafs. The whisper begins as a thought, and then an idea. From an idea to a desire. From a desire to determination and resolve. From that to an action. And if you don't do something about that, then that action becomes a habit. It's too late. Can't get rid of it. It's too late. It is you. Now you are known as a liar. You are known now as a liar because you let those thoughts come into your mind. You are known as a person who's loose with women because it began as a thought. It began as a mere thought and you didn't do anything about it. One of the companions of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abdullah ibn Abbas, radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he was approached by one of his students, Abu Sumayl, Samak ibn al-Walid, rahimahullah ta'ala. فقال Abu Sumayl, rahimahullah ta'ala, Ya Abdullah, Ya Abdullah, O Abdullah. He said, I asked Abdullah ibn Abbas, he said, أو عبد الله ما شيء أجده في صدري. What is this thing that I find in my chest? What is this thing that I find going around lingering in my heart? What is it? Abdullah ibn Abbas, he said, ma huwa? He said, what is it? He said, what is it? He said, wallahi, wallahi, I swear by Allah, I swear by Allah, I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to talk about it. It is so tremendous, in other words. Those thoughts that come to my chest, to my mind, I don't want to talk about it. Abdullah ibn Abbas, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, a shay'un min shakkin, is it something of doubt? Qad wa dhahika. So then he laughed. So then Abdullah ibn Abbas, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, فَإِن كُنْتَ, he recited the book of, recited an ayah from the book of Allah, فَإِن كُنْتَ فِي شَكٍ مِمَّا أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ فَاسْأَلِ الَّذِينَ يَقْرَؤُونَ الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ. He says, if you have any doubt of that which we have revealed, Allah says, if you have any doubt whatsoever from that which we revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then you should ask the people, those people came before you who recite the book, who read the book, meaning the Jews and the Christians, the Kitabiyun, the Ahl Kitab. Ask them if you have any doubt whatsoever, meaning if any evil suggestions come from you, come to you, then ask those people who received the scriptures before you, because the same things that are happening to you happened to the people of Moses' time and happened to the people in Jesus' time, the same thing. Then Abdullah ibn Abbas, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, when that happens to you, if you find anything, إِذَا وَجَدْتَ فِي نَفْسِكَ شَيْئًا فَقُلْ اللَّهُ هُوَ الْأَوَّلُ وَالْآخِرُ وَالظَّاهِرُ وَالْبَاطِنُ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ. He says, when you find anything inside of you that comes like this, then you should say, Allah, He is Al-Awwal and Al-Akhir and Al-Zahir and Al-Batin, and He has power and He has knowledge over everything. He has knowledge over everything. If you say that, then those evil suggestions will leave you. Those evil suggestions that come to your mind, those thoughts, those reprehensible ideas, will leave you immediately. هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وأخره.